Hey, very fast, 29th of August, 2019, and I pray you're all blessed. It's been very busy around here. This is the time of year where we prepare for the long, hard winter ahead, which I am not looking forward to, but praise God, we have the means and the wherewithal to do it. So that's what I've been doing, and I was out in the back 40 again. I got some wood seasoning out there, and I went out to check on that. And check this out.
It's, the 28th of August, and I had to show you this. I was back in the back 40 here again. I had a couple cord of wood seasoning out here. And I'm looking around, and I start to notice, like, wow, this tree is getting overtaken here. Out here in the middle of the woods. And upon further observation, I see I got wild grapes growing out here, which is like, I mean, come on, man. Out here in the middle of the woods, clusters of wild grapes that look like they're probably about 2 weeks or so away from ripening. And it's taken over these trees out here. Like it's just pulling that tree down. Crazy, man. I haven't been out here in like a couple few years. And I never knew that I had wild grapes growing out here. Isn't that crazy? All glory to God.
So I find these wild grapes growing out there. And you gotta understand the conditions and things. It's just not normal. There's very little sunlight back there. It's just really crazy. I mean, it really is. But I find these wild grapes yesterday on the 28th, okay? Now, when you see how this all kind of, like, comes together, this pattern is just really interesting, to say the least. 28, 14 times 2, right? The wild grapes. So I go to the Bible, and the grapes, the first mention of grapes is in Genesis 40, 10, 14. The last mention of grapes in the Bible is Revelation 14, 18, which is also filled with wrath. Revelation 14, which you should go read, as well as Genesis 40, as well as the whole Bible, okay? And this, of course, made me think of the Grapes of Wrath, which is a pretty amazing piece of literature you really should read if you haven't. The movie's pretty good, too. But that took place during the Great Depression. And I found it very interesting that over the last several days, this is one of the main themes we've been seeing, is to do with the economy. Because there is a massive depression coming. You better be prepared for it, that's all I can say. And they had the picture of the Treasury building on the front of Drudge for 2 solid days, which just doesn't happen, you know what I mean? This stuff is coming, you guys. But the Grapes of Wrath, right? That was all about family, the depression, the generations is very, very interesting. That book, though, that came out on April 14th, 1939, 414. Again, the 14 pattern just continues to go, right? If we go to yesterday when I found the grapes, okay, that's actually 29,356 days. 3 plus 5 plus 6 is a 14. It was 80 years, 4 months, and 14 days. You can go check this out, you guys. All right? From 4/14/39 is 80 years, 4 months, and 14 days. You just can't make this stuff up. And the wrath, you know, the grapes of wrath, also is found in Revelation 14. This is very interesting stuff, you guys. And it has to do with the economy. It has to do with so many things. I just pray that you're in Christ and you have that peace within you that gives you the understanding of who you are and where we are in time, and that you are secure in Christ. That's all that matters right now. Matthew 1 talks about the 14 generations, the 3 sets of 14 generations, Abraham to David. You got to go read this stuff, man. But Abraham, 1996 BC is the best, you know, research that I can find of when Abraham died, okay? I'm not 100% positive, but this 1996 BC shows up a lot, okay? So that puts us 1996 years to the year zero, which was named because of Christ. That BC is before Christ. AD is Anno Domini, in the year of our Lord. So if we go out 1996 years, the same distance from Abraham to Jesus, we wind up 23 years into the last generations. Think about this. This is absolutely crazy. The last of the 14 generations. You will know them by their fruit. Okay? Be very, very careful, very wise, yet very gentle as to who you listen to. It's our responsibility as individuals to maintain a relationship with our Creator through Christ. It's just that simple. If you're following any one man and putting your hope and faith in that man and in their doctrine without going and investigating these things for yourself, then you're just setting yourself up for a big old fall. And you will know them by their fruit. Matthew 7:16, 7:6-1, 14. Luke 6:44, 6:4-4, 14. And I could go on and on. It really is true. But bottom line, we are at the end of days. Regardless of who or what you believe, it doesn't change the fact that we are there. Okay? And only Jesus saves. We're talking eternity here, folks. That's a long time. You need to seriously consider, contemplate these things. Think on them. Call on the name of Jesus and ask for the truth. It's the only way you're going to find it. So I pray this blesses someone. I pray you're all good. I do have an awful lot of other things that have been given to us over the last several days that I'm making notes on. In regards to 9/11, the Sanhedrin 70 nations, the peace plan. So many things, you guys, just coming together in this one time frame that we're in right now. So keep looking up. Keep prayed up. Peace and grace to y'all. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,